Okay, let's get more on insight and analysis on this developing story. Oliver Shina Okeleje is a football journalist based in Lagos, Nigeria. Good to have you on the program. Which countries do you think may be interested in stepping in to host this event? You might think Nigeria. There's a school of thought that Nigeria, the current African champions, could potentially host.
Well, we've heard from Nigerian officials. They did say they would love and relish the opportunity to host, but the Nigerian government has actually played that down. They have a big elections next year in Nigeria, and they don't welcome such a tournament of that magnitude. But what we know for sure is that Egypt have actually ruled themselves out. CAF met with the officials of Egypt, and they said they're pulling out due to, they are not interested because of financial and political reason. Gabon, who co-hosted in 2002 with Equatorial Guinea, has been mentioned, but they only have two stadiums. Angola hosted in 2010. They have the stadia and the financial ability to host at short notice. But interestingly, Algeria is one of the seven nations who have decided that they want to host in the 2017 tournament, and they are the only ones who are readily available and who could actually step in as host come 2015.
So Algeria front runners at this stage, in your opinion, but if you look at the bigger scheme of things, it all seems like a bit of a mess leaving it this late to pull off such a massive event. Would you say CAF is to blame for this?
Well, I think it's a very difficult one to answer. I think CAF have not really covered themselves in glory. The moment designated host Morocco say that they are not ready to host because of the Ebola issues, and they also proposed an idea to CAF. Could we have it in June 2015? Could we have it in 2016, if possible? But CAF refused. CAF just said, look, we have sponsors to protect. We also have TV and all of those things to actually look at. Some countries are prepared for this tournament. You can't do that to them. So I think Ebola did not write Morocco any letter to say it was coming. It's a very unfortunate situation. I just think the blame should go to Morocco 50%, and 50% should go to CAF, the organizers, who insist that this tournament should go ahead as planned.
It was almost inevitable that Morocco would be disqualified from next year's tournament. They also, one of their officials, occupies a very high-profile job in CAF. Do you see this causing a split within CAF, this whole issue of Morocco?
Well, I don't think so. I think the executive committee have actually looked for a way. I understand they proposed to Morocco to ask some countries not to come to the country. They should still go ahead and host as planned. And in controlling Ebola, their fears of Ebola, they should prevent some countries from coming. Morocco outrightly rejected that. I don't think this will cause problem within CAF. I just think executive committee of CAF are really, really disturbed right now. They are understandably upset with Morocco. And I think Morocco are ready to pay the fine. They're ready to pay the sanctions. They might be suspended from the not just the 2015 edition, but I think the 2017 edition as well. And that's a very bad one for Moroccan football fans, as well as their footballers.
Expert analysis there from Oluwaseuni Okeleje, a football journalist based in Lagos, Nigeria. Thank you very much for that.